Witamy w kolejnym odcinku z serii Ten Major. Dzisiaj powiemy o Kolonii 16. Po fantastycznym majorze w Kolonii w 2015 roku nadszedł czas na kontynuację. W dniach od 5 lipca do 10 lipca 2016 roku w Lanxess Arena miał miejsce 9 major z kolei. W tym obiekcie mieści się 15 tysięcy miejsc, jednak nie zawsze były one wypełnione. Lokalizacja dostaje 4 gwiazdki. Overwatch, but here we go, it's Taz to trade out. Taking down device, 4v4 now. Flash has come in, they've blinded up Taz for a second, but he takes another fight and he wins it. Snacks fights on Taz! Inhuman performance from him going above and beyond for his side. Now Carrigan left in the 1v3, players left right and center, and it's Virtus Pro to pick up map 1. Pierwszy raz na majorze zorganizowanym przez ESLA mieliśmy krótkie opóźnienia. Najdłuższe sięgały 15 minut, a czasami mecze zaczynały się punktualnie. Pauzy techniczne występowały, ale bardzo rzadko. Kasterzy na tym turnieju wyglądali świetnie, jednak niektórzy byli niepotrzebni. Tak samo jak na MLG mieliśmy tutaj prize pool wynoszący $1 000 000. Organizacja również 4 gwiazdki. He has to keep Virtus Pro alive. A start, a good shot on the cold. Taco wants closer. AWP, and he's done it! Neo's hit both! We're going to overtime!
Major bronią Brazylijczycy z SK Gaming. Organizację zmienili tuż przed turniejem, ale skład pozostał bez zmian. W finale pokonali swoich rywali z półfinału MLG, czyli Team Liquid, w którym grał nowy zawodnik JDM. Finał tego turnieju był jednym z najgorszych, jeśli chodzi o widowisko. SK bez problemu wygrało 2-0. Dobrych meczów na tym turnieju było niewiele. Półfinał Fnatic Liquid był jednym z nich. Zadbał o to Simple, który wygrał klatcha 1-2 z AWP-ą dwoma skołpami, dzięki czemu dostał za to Graffiti. Pro mecz wygrała drużyna Bardolfa. Astralis zagrało dobry mecz z Virtus Pro w ćwierćfinale, mimo że grali z dwoma standinami, Glaive'em i Tenerem Zonikiem. Ważną rzeczą, jeśli nie najważniejszą, było zwycięstwo Flipside nad Nipem, przez co Nip stracił status legendy i nie odzyskał go aż do teraz. 3 gwiazdki. Trying to take the match over the line. What is that? What just happened? Elise just killed two of his teammates.
To na tyle, widzimy się za tydzień. Cześć! Contact play so far. Flipside is down to Getright, who has to be the last standing bastion here. The backup's on the way, but it's Getright doing it all day again. Goes in for the third, he gets it, and Flipside being shredded down by one man. Open a deagle. No time though, 15 seconds. What? Neo gets two with one shot then, a deagle coming in. Zipic's not gonna check it. Oh, the giant trigger discipline, the lineup. He's got two. He's given himself a chance. And there's low HP on Kerrigan with AWP. They have to get back to this bomb. They've got 45 seconds to do it. And it's Config that's gonna make the move first. He gets off the platform. He could totally surprise them all. As he pops back out, it's Device to go down. Config, this is a huge, huge round because this was potentially in a 1v4 map point for Astralis. And as mentioned, Kerrigan is low on HP. He's trying desperately to find the op pick, still behind the wall at top middle. He's gotten a little bit closer to the van. Config watching the angle and he's done it. 1v4. Turning around, quick shot, drops the bomb on Apex, and now the full rotation is going to happen. They already know, great shot from Chris, turning around, that's the triple kill. Chris J just shot his Envy out of the round, that's the quad right then and there. What a round from Chris. Zeus finally to come on the lead, 2 now,
And this is why I think it's going to be a seaside map in the future, that split potential you have. And it's so easy to get towards heaven, the CTs kind of forget that's a possibility sometimes, especially with so much aggro here. But Hiko doing what he can, finds two, gives him a chance there with three.
Hiko goes absolutely mad.
In the same place there, Simple just jumping, casually into the side, he's gonna fall down and get under the right. What is this truck from Simple? Are you serious? What is that? You can't do that, Simple. That's not allowed. This is not FPL. This is a major.
James Simple is an assassin. This guy is absolutely unbelievable. He's the X Factor for Team Liquid. There is no question.
Almost dying from the jump there. At least putting in work though. 3 versus 3 now, and that bomb might just go down. But how many players will they have left once it does? Hiko doing his best to cover his teammate. Kenyas comes out. Kenyas can't be stopped for the moment. Elise alone now versus 3. You know he's got high sense. That's a nice two-man spray down. Where's the last man? There's no. He has enough bullets. That is an unbelievable clutch there for Elise.
That's one of the AWPs still with vision. He's got two. He can spoil his round for Fnatic as he finds Dennis a third. And a fourth for AZ as he jumps over and finds Flusha. This time, he's got two. Great transfer onto Neo. Snack's trying to find the equalizer, but look at Cole go. You're talking about double off. He goes down four. He's got an ace in overtime.